Dear students, in this lecture we are going to study one of the type of this gravimetry, that is precipitation gravimetry. So we must know what is mean by gravimetric estimation and what is the objective of gravimetric estimation. Basically, the gravimetric estimation is a method of quantitative chemical analysis. So here we are going to determine the quantity of a compound, therefore it is a quantitative chemical analysis, and in which the constituent is converted into a substance of known composition that can be separated from the sample, and it is weighted after that. So from the solution we are going to prepare a compound of known composition, and from that we are going to weigh that sample, and from that we can determine the composition of the ions present in the substance. So what is an objective of this gravimetric estimation? So here we determine the mass or the concentration of substance by measuring a change in mass. So during this experiment, the change in mass gives us the information regarding the presence of an ion or presence of a compound in this experiment. So in today's lecture we are going to study this one of these four fundamental types of gravimetry is precipitation gravimetry. So during performing this precipitation gravimetry, we must know different steps which are required for this gravimetric analysis. Initially, the first step is we have to prepare the test solution. Second, we have to precipitate that test solution. Third, the digestion of precipitate. Fourth, we have to filter that digested precipitate. Finally, we have to wash the precipitate. And after that, after washing that precipitate, the sixth step is we have to ignite or we have to dry that precipitate. After drying, the seventh step is we have to weigh that compound, and finally we have to take the calculation. So there are different 8 steps which are required to perform this precipitation gravimetry. One is preparation of test solution, precipitation, digestion, filtration, washing, drying or ignition of the precipitate, weighing of that compound, and finally come to the calculation. So this gravimetric precipitation involves the precipitation of metal ions from a suitable reagent by maintaining proper conditions of pH and temperature of the solution. So maintaining the proper pH of the solution and temperature during the experiment, we are going to precipitate that metal ion with different suitable reagents. So when we are maintaining this pH and temperature, we are getting the precipitate. So mainly there are 3 different types of precipitates can be formed. So it may be a crystalline, it may be a curdy, or it may be a gelatinous precipitate. So these 3 different types of precipitates may be formed during this precipitation gravimetric estimation. So we must know the conditions for precipitation then. So if you want to prepare a good compound, a good precipitate, then we must know the different conditions required for the precipitation. First, we are going to see what is actually need of different conditions to maintain during this precipitation. Look at here, the completeness of a precipitation process depends on equilibrium solubility of a precipitate. So during the formation of precipitation process or during the precipitation process, that process depends upon the equilibrium solubility, and we must know what is the solubility product and equilibrium solubility. So precipitation is an ionic reaction, and here the positive ion of one substance is combining with negative ion of another substance, and it forms a sparingly soluble substance. So here the positive ion is combining with the negative ion, and it forms sparingly soluble compound. And most of the precipitates in analytical chemistry are sparingly soluble, and which behave like a strong electrolyte and are completely ionized. So in analytical chemistry, most of the precipitates are sparingly soluble and they behave like a strong electrolyte and are completely ionized. The solubility of any substance is defined as the amount of substance dissolved in its saturated solution in a given solvent at a given temperature and is expressed in gram per dm cube. Means solubility is nothing but the substance, amount of substance dissolved in a saturated solution in a given solvent at a given temperature. The solubility product now is defined as the product of concentration or activities of constituents raised to the appropriate power depending on the number of ions present in a molecule of the compound at a given temperature. So solubility product is nothing but it is a product of concentration term of different ions present in a molecule of a compound. So this both solubility and solubility products are temperature dependent. So if you increase the temperature, the solubility and solubility product also increases. So solubility increases as temperature increases, solubility product also increases with increase in temperature. So we know that if you increase the temperature of a beaker, if compound is there, then the compound is going to be dissolved more and more. This is a solubility and it depends upon the temperature coefficient. The most important condition or a primary condition for a precipitation of substance to form from its solution is that the product of molar concentration of its ions exceed the solubility product. Means what? The concentration of ions must be exceed than the solubility product of substance. So then and then only the precipitation is going to be formed. Thus, when ionic product is greater than solubility product, precipitation takes place. So this question will be asked in the MCQ that the ionic product is greater than solubility product, then precipitation takes place or not. So ionic product must be greater than solubility product for the precipitation. So in general, now see here, ionic product must be greater than solubility product, then precipitation takes place. If both of them, that is ionic product is equal to solubility product, then the solution is saturated. And if the solubility product is greater than IP, that is ionic product, then unsaturated solution, that is solution is not saturated. So this is what the basic conditions required for the precipitation, that is ionic product must be greater than solubility. We must know what is meant by solubility. We must know what is meant by solubility product during this experiment. So what are the different types of precipitate will be formed? We have seen just, and what are the steps? So this is the basic information which is required for this gravimetric analysis.